Hello, Avengers and Marvel gaming fans! Welcome to part 6 of my LEGO Marvel Avengers DLC playthrough and the finale of my LEGO Marvel Avengers DLC playthrough, as this is the last DLC that I have to do, which is the Masters of Evil DLC, where we get to play as villains like Baron Zemo. So it's been quite a while since my last LEGO Marvel Avengers video. I think it was back in like April or May, somewhere around there. And I did the Agent Shield one, and I wasn't too fond of that one. And I think so far my favorite one was either the Captain Marvel one, which I think I said was my favorite because Captain America was in it. And I also enjoyed the Black Panther one. But yeah, it's been quite a while. I'm sorry for the lack of content that I had last month. I did have plans to do Corpse Party, but the thing was is that I for one, like, I was dealing with copyright problems with Friday the 13th Part 3, and you know how that went. It fell through, and I couldn't, you know, get it back up, so I had to put it on my backup sites. But also, I just wasn't feeling motivated enough to do it. Like, I just wasn't in the right kind of mindset that I wanted to be for Corpse Party. So that's why I ended up not doing it. So I'm very sorry about that. I will make it up to you guys next year, as I just did post a poll as well as an update for what's going on this month and you know, what will be going on during Scooby month. But I did just post a poll so you can vote there on what two properties you want me to cover, whether it be one of the four choices I lay out or whether you want something else. Please let that be known. But yeah, and also, this won't be the last LEGO Marvel Avengers video, as I did find out that there are three bonus levels that along with the main game. So there's the Iron Man 3 bonus level, which is based on the film, the Thor 2 bonus level, which is based on that film, and the Captain America 2 one, which is the last one, based on that level. So that's how I'm gonna go. Like, after this one, it'll be Iron Man 3, Thor 2, Captain America 2. We'll save the best for last, for that, out of those three. If this does well, we'll do those bonus levels. If not, we'll just, you know, move on to whichever game it be, which might be Friday the 13th, or it might be Spider-Man, if things go well. But yeah, in my last video, like I said, I had a Friday the 13th Part 3 review. I hope you guys enjoyed that. And my last game video, like I said, I did the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. plotline, which I didn't like. So let's hope we end well with this final DLC and see if the story, you know, gives us a satisfying, you know, conclusion to this little DLC playthrough. So I think that's enough exposition jump right there. We've pretty much covered everything, so let's begin this final DLC and see if the Masters of Evil it will be a good, an average, or a bad DLC. So let's go. So, story, are you sure? Yes. Halloween was pretty disappointing this year, though.
The most powerful bonding agent known to man. Only I, the brilliant Baron Zemo, could conceive of using it to bring the meddlesome Avengers to a sticky end, once and for all. Joining my clingy crusade was a gruesome grouping of super criminal cohorts, Radioactive Man, Black Knight, and the mysterious Melter. Together, we formed the Masters of Evil. Soon the Avengers' fate would be sealed.
Interesting. Yeah, Halloween was pretty disappointing this year. It wasn't the worst Halloween I've had. I've had worse, but it definitely wasn't as good as I was hoping
for. My agents had done well to hide the adhesive X canisters in the city. All that was required now was to find and activate them. I was certain that the Avengers would try to stop us.
I also saw saw X in September, which I loved. That's one of my favorite series, so
The melter. Even Iron Man's armor is no match for his newly... I remember contemplating the delicious irony of our magnificent master plan.
Right, left, down. The idea of playing Marvel villains is a neat idea for a DLC.
The power of Adhesive X, the city that had become so
attached. But besides Baron Zemo, I'm not too familiar with the other villains.
Permanently attached to it. Radioactive man, able to withstand even the hammer of Thor. Truly, he belongs with the masters of evil.
Never too busy to help out a hero in times of...
The Black Knight, a powerful warrior, consumed only with getting revenge on his adversaries.
How to get up there? Let's destroy this because this is clearly being shown as something. Pull that out, Black Knight. Yeah, not one of my best Halloweens, but definitely not the worst one I've had. But it was no last year. Like last year was, you know, something else. But this year, it was not that great this year. Which was a shame, because I was hoping to really scare people with my Jason costume. We'll see how I do next year with Freddy Krueger.
This will defeat a lesser man, but not I.
Now, where to go from here? Get up there somehow. Fuck off, cops. Where to go?
Hey, give me a hand, will you?
Trying to help villains.
This will defeat a lesson. Not a...
Hmm. That did something. Fuck off, cops.
No matter the obstacle, Hydra always achieved its goals. Even if the Hydra field manual made
no specific
mention of bouncing on shop canopies.
Took a little bit for me to find where it was, but there it is. Up we go, Zemo. Left, down, up. There's that one. Sorry, Stanley, I wish I could help you. Here comes Iron Man.
As we had anticipated, the Avengers began to arrive. First was Iron Man, whose misguided attempts to stop us would only make our victory all the more glorious. This would defeat a lesser man, but not us.
That's cool, we get to fight Iron Man. That's an interesting idea. Alright, Tony, where are you? Oh, thanks, Tony. You really helped me a bunch there by destroying that. Cop, leave me alone. I'm building something.
Iron Man was no match for our combined might. The Masters of Evil forced him to retreat with his metal tail between his metal legs.
I gotta say, like, at least it's more interesting than the S.H.I.E.L.D. one, because my god was that Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. one awful. I was so bored throughout that one, because honestly, I'm not a fan of S.H.I.E.L.D. In the show, but like, it just also was not like, you know, when you don't know the show that well, it just really doesn't gel with you at all. Pull that down. Assassin's Creed Mirage and Spider-Man 2, which I do hope to play on my channel one day. I do plan on playing the all the Assassin's Creed games on the channel eventually, and I'll play Spider-Man 2 once I've beaten the first game on my channel. But it's definitely been a great time, you know, playing them. Still one left that we've missed somewhere. don't know where it is.
This would defeat a lesser man, but not I.
Leave me alone, I'm doing
something.
I've often
found that appearances can be deceiving. For those with connections to Hydra, power can be found anywhere.
Oh, there he is.
Even hidden in plain sight.
Time to joust, my fellow police officer. That's right, get that down. Oh, that's cool. Zemo was able to get access to S.H.I.E.L.D.'s database. Not surprising, considering his nature. Taste my sword. Alright, up we go. Final one, let's go. Up, up, left. Now there's that one. Thor. Come on, Thor, let's go.
And so came the mighty Thor. His hammer was said to be unstoppable, but we will put that to the test.
Come back here, Thor. Powering up again, are you, Thor?
Not even the God of Thunder could stop us. I suppose you could say he tried Asgard as he could. Just at the point of victory, with the city at its knees, our evil plan became unstuck. Those tricky Avengers had swapped my dastardly glue for solvent, releasing my captives. Yet I remain undeterred, for I, Zemo, never surrender. It is my destiny to rule, and rule I... Wait, is that a smoke bomb? I'll get you, Avengers! Just your wait!
That's a nice little villain side story. Very short one, too. Not as long as I expected it to be. The Masters of Evil, level complete. Very interesting. Very nice short villain level. Nice little side story. We got to fight Iron Man and Thor. That was pretty cool. Honestly, it wasn't the worst one to end on. At least it wasn't as bad as Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.'s level. The S.H.I.E.L.D. one was... You could tell I was not invested in that one because I was talking everything else but the playthrough in that game. Because it was just that uninteresting to me. But I still say the Captain Marvel level was definitely the best one. And that's saying something considering I'm not a huge fan of Captain Marvel. But... because it had Captain America in it, that was a plus. And I think I love, and then after that, I think it was the Black Panther level, which I really enjoyed. And then I would say, I think it was Ant-Man after that, Doctor Strange below Ant-Man. As far as the Masters of Evil level goes, it was decent enough. It was all right. Like, it wasn't, I wouldn't call it good, I guess, but I wouldn't call it bad. Maybe I would put it maybe above, like, either Ant-Man or Doctor Strange, somewhere in the middle like that. Definitely above one of the heroes. Maybe Doctor Strange. Maybe it's below. Maybe I would put the Masters of Evil below Ant-Man, but not above Doctor Strange's DLC. Not because I hated Doctor Strange's DLC. You know, I love Doctor Strange as a character, but they just didn't do him well enough in that DLC that, you know. And the Ant-Man one was just based on the movie, and it was very bland and generic. Not bad, but, you know, because it's held back by the movie, it doesn't, you know, doesn't have the same resonation, you know, because I already know the film. So I'd probably say this is probably in between those, because it's a nice little side story. It's probably, like, but it could maybe even be above Ant-Man. But the S.H.I.E.L.D. one, definitely the worst one. So, yeah, that's all of them. And personally, I would recommend the two best ones out of them are probably the Captain Marvel and Black Panther ones. Go get those DLCs. Besides those, the other DLCs are up to you. I personally think it's depends on how much you love the character and how much you enjoyed these Let's Play videos and whether you thought any of these appealed to you. But yeah, that's it for this DLC. That's the end of our series. A nice little short gameplay video to end it off. And now we just have 3 bonus levels left. So we're not quite done with LEGO Marvel Avengers yet, unless if you guys, you know, want something else. But if you guys do love what you're seeing and want more, then I will definitely continue with the 3 bonus levels of Iron Man 3, Thor 2, and Captain America 2. And then we can say goodbye to LEGO Marvel Avengers after a long Let's Play of it, and then maybe, and then, you know, if things go the way they can, you know, we'll move on to the Spider-Man game from 2018. But yeah, thank you guys so much for joining me. I had a great time going through all these DLC levels and showcasing them. These were new experiences for me. The bonus levels will be new experiences, but considering they're based on films that I've seen before, they won't be anything new to me, you know, story-wise, but gameplay wise it'll be something new that I haven't played before. So yeah, if you're interested in more, then please let me know. But yeah, if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and give it a like. If you did, comment down below your thoughts on this game. What do you think of the DLC levels? Which one's your favorite? Which one did you enjoy the most? And you know, do you enjoy the series? Do you want to see me play the bonus levels, or you want me to move do another game? You know, whatever you want to talk about, you know, just leave it down in the comment section below. We'll discuss it. And subscribe for more Marvel gaming and Avengers content like this, or if you're just interested in any of my other content. I'll be doing plenty of Marvel video games in the future. That much is clear, you know. But not every Marvel character, obviously. Just the character, like I said many times before in the past, just the characters that I like, just the ones that I'm big on and care about, unless if you guys are interested in, you know, me tackling a game on a character that I'm not too fond of, which I doubt you would. But and I'll also do the other Avengers game, the 2021, you know, because that's the only other Avengers game out there. I'll probably end up doing that in the future. You know, obviously it doesn't have a good reputation, but that doesn't mean we can't, you know, play through it and go through the story and then just kind of end it there and not really bother with it. I think the servers pretty much are gone from the multiplayer. Not that I care much, because I'm not a multiplayer guy. I much prefer single player, story focused games. Multiplayer, very rarely, you know, unless if it's like a horror video game like Texas Chainsaw Massacre or Friday the 13th or Dead by Daylight. Very rarely do I play multiplayer games. They're just not my cup of tea. But yeah, that's that. You can subscribe for any of those stuff. And you can also follow me on Facebook, where I have discussions about things we talk about on both my channels, and Twitch, where I hope to live stream in the future. So on my next video, I will be tackling Season 1, Episode 6 of Miraculous Ladybug and Cat Noir. We're going to be getting back into Miraculous Ladybug and Cat Noir. It's been quite a while since I tackled the show. Of course, you guys all know that I've changed my branding to Scooby-Doo, and that's my primary focus. So yes, Scooby-Doo is still the main focus of the channel. I still love Scooby-Doo to death. It's probably the main thing I want to cover the most on this channel. But I want to have some variety in my content and give you guys more than just Scooby-Doo, because I do love other things than Scooby-Doo. And Miraculous is one of those things, and I haven't really tackled it in a while. And so I'm really excited to, you know, to dive back into it, especially now that I have that DVD for it, and now I can, you know, cover it based on DVD, and then, you know, when we finish that, we can go through the special features. But yeah, you can look forward to that. So if you're interested in my next Miraculous Ladybug and Cat Noir review, then stay tuned. That'll be coming up next. But if you're looking forward to the next gaming video, that'll probably come sometime after that video, maybe a little while after that, because I am working on some future projects. One is a game review on a character that did appear in this level, one of his older games, a sequel to one of his older games that I played. That was the third game I played on my channel when I started my channel. And I'm also going to be doing a special review for my favorite slasher down the line next year, because there will be, because you guys know the deal. There's two Friday the 13th next year, so I'll be tackling two films of that series for, you know, my favorite slasher, Mr. Jason Voorhees. But yeah, those are my future projects. But yeah, we'll see how this goes, and if you want, and we'll do more Lego Marvel Avengers if you guys want more. If not, we'll do something else, whichever one, you know, you guys want, or whichever one I end up picking. But that's all I gotta say. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and as always, peace out.